Did you know that display in CSS has fairly recently become a multi-keyword property? Stick to the end of this video and find out exactly what this means, why it's important, and how multi-value or multi-keyword display property works. I have a simple demo here. Please ignore the markup. It's not okay. It's intentionally created this way so I can show you exactly what I want to show you. There's a little bit of text on the page, a container. Container again contains a little bit of text with a link, a break, and an image. You can probably view this as a media object. Let's jump to our CSS, and here we will work with the container element, and container is this div element, this block that you see right here that contains this text about CSS Weekly. By default, as you know, a div element has a display value set to block, and this is exactly what you see here in this media object in this container. This is a block level element, and of course we can change it if we set display property to inline. Let's try that. And if we do this, you're going to see how this element is rendered on the page changes, and now it no longer has its own box. It's actually flowing in line with the rest of the content with this text right here. So as you probably understand, display inline or display block actually change how this element is rendered in the context of its container, or rather on the page itself in this particular example. And of course, we're dealing with the div element here, which means that its default value is going to be display block. But what if we, for example, had a span element instead of a div? So I'll change my HTML here and I will tweak my container element and set it to span. Closing tag will also be span. There we go. And now by default, this element will be inline. I will remove this display property just so you can see exactly that it makes no difference here. But of course, we can also set it to block. In that case, it will behave as a block level element. Until now, I was talking about block and inline values for display property, and you probably know exactly how those work, and those actually affect how element is positioned within the context of its container. But we also have newer properties, specifically flexbox and grid, and those behave a little bit differently. So I'll change display here to flex. And now you're going to see that this container actually behaves in the context of its surroundings as a block level element. Its children, or rather, this text, this link, this text, and this image are laid out according to flexbox rules. And by default, the direction for the flexbox is flex row, so this is exactly what you see here. So essentially, what flexbox does, and grid works exactly in the same way, it affects how element is rendered in the context of its surroundings and how element's children are rendered. So it does two different things, and that's exactly why we also have inline flex and inline block values. So let's try setting inline flex here. What this does is it sets its children to flexbox as before, but now the element is in the context of its surroundings rendered as an inline element. And you don't see any difference here because this element is too big, but if we set its inline size to something like 300 pixels, you're going to see that it falls in line with text. And I'm going to resize my window now so you can see exactly that this is how it works. If we remove the inline keyword here and we just have flex, which means that element will be rendered as a block level element, it will fall in its own line. And this, as you can see, actually means that display property does two separate things. It changes how element behaves in its surroundings, and potentially it changes how its children behave. And that is exactly why display property was refactored and it was changed to accept multi-keyword value. Essentially, this means that we have an outer keyword value and inner keyword value. Block and inline represent an outer keyword value, and flex and grid, for example, represent inner keyword value. Inner value affects children, and the outer value affects how element is rendered in its surroundings. So in our particular example, here we would have display inline space flex. So instead of inline minus flex like we had before, new two keyword syntax would be defined as inline flex. Or if we want to have a block level element, then we will specify it not just as a flex, but rather as a block space flex. And as you can see right now, it behaves exactly as you would expect. I'll just remove this inline size now. All previous values that were possible have new mappings that correspond exactly to the new two keyword syntax values. And everything is backward compatible. And speaking of that, all modern browsers at the moment of recording of this video already support multi-keyword syntax, so you can start using this immediately. Let's just really quickly jump into MDM documentation so I can show you exactly those mappings. Here we go. This is the old value, and this is the new value. So of all the values that you see here, you're already familiar with block and inline and flex and grid. But flow and flow root might be something a bit newer. Flow means that element lays out its contents using flow layout, which is actually the default layout, default behavior of any web page. So that's exactly why display block maps to block flow and why display inline maps to inline flow. This is exactly what you always had. This is exactly how elements behave on a page by default. And a newer property, flow root, is fairly similar, but the difference with this property is that it actually creates a new block formatting context. And a block formatting context defines how a web page is rendered, or rather, a web page itself is the first block rendering context that we have on HTML page, which means that nothing can come out of that particular box. So all margins, all elements will be confined within that particular block. There are numerous ways you can define a new block formatting context, like using the overflow property, for example, but flow root specifically will create a new block formatting context, which was created exactly for the purpose of containing elements within a certain block, for example, when dealing with floats. Instead of dealing with floats or clearing floats using the clearfix or specifically setting overflow property, you can actually use flow root to contain a certain element, or rather to contain all its children within its box. I'll show you now exactly how this works. Let's jump to our demo back, and here let's set our display to block flow, which will be default value block, and let's set image to float. And you see here immediately that image is outside of this particular box where we assigned it, or rather our container element. And the reason for that is that the block formatting context for this particular demo right now is HTML page itself. So this element is laid out on the context of the entire page. We can override that by creating a new block formatting context for this particular element. And one way to do that would be to set the overflow property. Let's try this. I'll set on my container element overflow to auto. Now you see that the container has expanded and its boundaries actually include an image. Of course, setting the overflow property on an element just to contain floats might not be ideal because you might get some unwanted side effects. Another way to deal with this particular issue would be to use a clearfix hack. For this, you would create an after pseudo element on container. You would set its contents to nothing, its display to block, and clear both. And this is basically a very hacky way to create a new block formatting context just so you can contain this particular float or this particular image in our example. And exactly that is the reason why the new value for display property or flow root was created. Flow root creates another block formatting context, exactly what this clearfix hack or this overflow property do, but without any side effects. So if we change this to flow root, you're going to see that this behaves exactly as you would expect. Our floated element is within its container. And this actually means that this container now behaves exactly as the root element on our page or our entire document. All elements that are within it will be contained within it and will not go outside of its boundaries. With all that being said, is there actually a realistic use case for two syntax display property? If you jump back into documentation, you're going to see that every value has a corresponding new value. And this really means that you don't gain anything, at least not in a moment, by using a two-value syntax. You can use a single value keywords, which will correspond exactly to what you want with the two-value syntax. Single values for display property are now considered legacy values. They will still be supported by browsers because browsers always tend to be backward compatible. But from this point forward, display property is officially treated as a two keyword property, which means that new values are what the browser will expect. So by switching to two keyword syntax, you're actually using display property as it's intended to use right now. And you're actually making it a little bit more clear of what display property does. By using the two value syntax, you will know exactly how box itself will be laid out on the page, which will be either block or inline, and you will understand exactly how its children will behave, which will be either flow, flow root, flex, or grid. So my recommendation is start using two value syntax because this is the new way of writing the CSS display property. By adopting this two keyword syntax, you're actually future-proofing your CSS. You're making it explicitly clear of how inner and outer display is set. And what do you think about all of this? Will you adopt a new two keyword syntax, or will you continue using the single keyword values? I'm really curious to know. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a new display value, or rather, in a new video.